Ben Reed here from The Hoot Show, and I'm back again for Tweets of the Week. I've got five tweets to go through this week. I'm going to keep it pretty short again, so I picked out my five favourite tweets for this week. Now, our first tweet is from Michael Faulkner, and Michael says, probably the best style of footy all year. They showed glimpses of this style last year, but never seemed to play it on a weekly basis. We need to bring that back ourselves on a weekly basis, and we can beat anyone. Yes, Michael, I loved what I saw on the weekend. I thought it was pretty special. The ball movement was glorious. The players just seemed to enjoy themselves as well, which is really a really important part of playing footy. There's nothing worse than running out there and you hate what you're doing and you hate this game style and all that. So, and look, we came up against an opponent that was probably allowing us to play that well a little bit. They did literally look like witches' hats out there, the Giants, for a fair chunk of the day. So they've got some problems there. And Leon Cameron, I think his days are numbered, unfortunately. I don't think that was a coach-killing game. I think he'll still be there next weekend. But we do have a history of sending coaches on their way at Geelong. But I think he'll be around a little bit longer. But yeah, love the style of play. It was fantastic, wasn't it, Michael? So thanks for your tweet. Now, our next tweet is from Mick. And I think we've had Mick on before, actually. Maybe once before. But Mick says, if there is a better club man than Mark Blitzarves, is there a better club man than Mark Blitzarves, how many teams have a player as versatile as him, willing to do anything, such as ruck against a literal giant? Did a superb job. Enjoyed seeing the younger players get a go. Thank you, Mick. I talked about Blitz in my match review or post-match review on Monday night. I thought he was fantastic. And he just does everything. He's a jack of all trades. You just tell him to do a job, he'll go and do it. You know, make a mistake here or there like everybody does. But you can't really fault the guy too much. It's no wonder he's won two best and fairest at Geelong, possibly a third coming up. It depends what the second half of the year looks like, but he's great. I'm really, really happy for him that a lot of us Cats fans maybe a bit too hard on him before because of the nature of the role he's had to play and this game style that can be a bit frustrating, especially with him where he's not great with his 20-metre, 30-metre kicks. But he's given a bit more freedom through the middle of the ground and with the instruction to just kick it long and move it quickly, and he takes a great mark. I am loving Blitz. He's climbing up the hoops ranking to my favourite players for the club. Closey's number one. No one's going to knock Closey out of number one. Be a cold day in hell when Closey loses the number one spot. But yeah, Blitz is climbing. He's coming hard. But don't worry, Closey, you're still my number one. I love you. Love you, Closey. Thanks, Mick. Now, Andrew S. Cowell, I think I've got that right, says, very happy with that. Two new ready-made kids who absolutely held up to the challenge. Stengel and Jez, big tick. All-round team performance. Just fingers crossed on Jed. It was a great all-round performance, wasn't it, Andrew? Looking at the best players on the ground, I thought Blitzarves was a clear standout. A standout for me. But there was easily probably 18 players that I think were above par. That were really sort of, and the others are probably just average. I guess I can't think of them who had a bad game necessarily. Jed clearly, you know, I'm not going to say Jed had a bad game. He didn't last long. But yeah, I thought everyone played great and everyone just played for each other and played for the system, played for the hoops. The Guernsey, the colours, I love it. I love the way they went about it on the weekend, Andrew. It was great to see. It's good to get back with a win. I am miserable for the whole week when the Cats lose. I can't always win, I know that. I did pick them to win 19 games this year, so we're going to have to go on a bit of a run. We've already dropped three, so I can't afford to drop another one. So Cats, don't lose any more games, otherwise I'm not going to look stupid, but... I was very bold in predicting Cats would win 19 games, but it's still a chance until we actually drop our fourth. It's on the cards. So, anyway, thank you, Andrew, for that one. Now, Jack says, Blitz is a machine. It's all about Blitz this week. Better team without Selwood, as much as that pains me. The under-25 squad looks strong. Sam DeConning, OSDK, is an absolute talent. Stengel is the recruit of the year. Now, I included this one, Jack. Maybe you're deliberately being controversial. I'm not sure. Goodness me. Geelong is better without Selwood. Jeez, if I had a red phone or hotline, it'd be ringing off the hook about now. I don't have that yet. I'll get there one day for you, Jack. But no, Selwood, I can't disagree with you any stronger on that one, Jack. I love your passion, but Selwood for mine. Look, I'm probably in the same boat as a few others that think maybe this is his last year, and maybe it's good for him to go out on top. I don't want him to sort of slide any further, but I feel like he's 100% in our best 22, if not in our best five players. Honestly, that's how I'm feeling about what he's doing for us. He's not getting his 35 touches, what he used to do back in the day, but I think he just brings us so much. And in saying that, I loved it. I loved the look on Tom Stewart's eyes, the captain, on the weekend. I think Tom's nearly ready to go. So at the very least, I think this could be Selwood's last year as the captain of the Catters. I think Tom Stewart is ready to go. Locked and loaded for 2023. Get on Tom for that year. So thanks, Jack. And Stengel, yes, 100%. I don't know about recruit of the year, but geez, he's been good, hasn't he? I have to have a bit more of a think about who the other recruits of the year have been. But yeah, a couple of little games where he wasn't fantastic to start the year off. But geez, the last couple of weeks, he's been glorious. Loving Stengel and loving Sam DeConning. Just all great. And we're playing a lot of kids, so it's really good to see us getting a couple of, giving the kids a go. They do get games. It's just that sort of age profile is an interesting one, isn't it? We've got a lot of older guys and a lot of younger guys, so it's sort of not that spread that seemingly a lot of other clubs have. But we're definitely playing a lot of young guys. They tend to sort of rotate in and out a little bit, but it's great to see them, and it's really great when you see a young player stand up. You think, well, maybe we'll be cheering this bloke on in another 10 years' time. You never know. I wasn't sure about Mitch Duncan 10 years ago, but look at him now. He'll go down as one of the greatest Geelong Cats players ever. And there's probably about 10 of them in the side now. That'll be one of the great. And that's none of them. And pretty much Hawkins and Selwood are the only ones that have won grand finals with Geelong since 2011. So, but there's lots of guns in that team. Even though they may end up without winning a grand final, they're going to retire with a lot of love from us Geelong supporters. Anyway, last tweet, I think it's the last. Yeah, last tweet of the week is from Trevor Young. And Trevor, I think this might be Trevor's second tweet on the show. But Trevor says, it's an important win on the road against a giant side that had everything to win for. The side could have been excused for being unsettled and all over the shop, but played with cohesion. New fellas contributed, and Sam DeConning continues to blossom. Doesn't he blossom? Isn't he gorgeous? I mean, I'll get a bit carried away. Now, he's a gorgeous player, and I'm loving what he's bringing to the team, and I'm just loving the fact that we're giving him so many opportunities, and the players are trusting him and allowing him to make the odd mistake. It's going to happen when you're young, but we're just trusting him. We're 5-3. We've got this bloke who's holding up fullback, and we're 5-3. Just think about that for a moment, Cats fans. Talk to another club that's 2-6, and tell me how they'd be feeling. They would be so envious of us being in the situation that we are. They had so many young players come through this year, and be in the position that we are with a nice run. I mean, St Kilda's going to be tough next week, but we've got a nice run at home coming up too. So it's this middle part of the year is where we normally will find our feet and string a few wins together. Doesn't mean it's going to happen, but historically this is where we find our groove a little bit, and we go from a sort of a 5-3 kind of team to a 8-3 kind of team, you know, that kind of thing. So let's wait and see over the next few weeks. But yeah, look, I think Trevor, I think your comments are great. They had everything to win, they had everything to play for, the Giants, but for one reason or another, they just can't seem to put it together this year. They're struggling a little bit. But then a few other teams are as well in the AFL that just, no, it's hard to explain why. It's just, sometimes it just doesn't click and other teams just pop up. That's the nature of the AFL industry, that there's always going to be a team that sort of steps up and a couple of other teams that maybe just not take things for granted, but time gets the better of them, and circumstance and a bit of bad luck thrown in as well. It's just the way it goes. Thankfully, Geelong's just one of those teams that year after year just seems to find a way to make finals, and seems to find a way to make top four, and seems to find a way to make first or second on the ladder year after year after year. It's a privilege to be a Geelong supporter, and we should never take that for granted. I just love the club. I'm feeling the love. You can probably tell them. I'm bouncing around this week. I'm just loving the Catters. So, yeah, happy day. So, thanks, Trevor. Thanks for everyone else sending a tweet that I didn't feature this week, but I really appreciate the interaction. I enjoy chatting with you guys throughout on the weekends and through the week. So, yeah, any ideas you want me to sort of include on the show, or any good thoughts you got, put them in the comments below. Let's interact. Let's chat. And I'll, yeah, tomorrow, what's tomorrow, Wednesday? Tomorrow's the Draft Wars with the Chaps Chat Cats, so check that show out, 8:30 tomorrow night. I'm looking forward to that. The boys seem to outdo themselves every week, so if you haven't seen that show yet, please check it out. I think last time they just had full face makeup and out of control, and Jake, unfortunately, Jake's had a bit of a bad week with the Draft Wars. He hasn't done too well. I won't say too much more than that, but an absolute shocker. For Jakey Boy from the Chaps Chat Cat. So check that one out. Anyway, that's me done. That's this show over and out. I will see you next time. See you, cats. Bye.